Remind me why I spent 2.5 hours washing the Silverado last night.
Thanks a lot for coming along with Life with BillSiff. Let's see what's really going on.
Can you see me? Probably not. Frank, how you doing today while in Life with BillSiff? Well, I took my truck into good old Ray Griffin there, Griffin Auto Tech, yesterday, and got some work done on her. I got 2 new wheel bearings put in her. I got 2 new drive shaft universals put in, an ABS sensor put in, a new gas cap, and look at the dash. I only have 1 light on and it's for the tire monitor system. We didn't do too freaking bad yesterday, but I wasted my money on universals for the drive shaft because it's still clicking. We're getting another one from the junkyard and trying it because that clicking's still there. If you see my video of the clicking drive shaft, then go watch it back there, way back somewhere. But it's been clicking for over 2 years, so it's not like it's falling apart. It's just something's broken inside. Every time you load it up, it clicks and snaps and cracks. There you go. If you have that problem below, let me know. Why wouldn't you? But thanks, Ray, for fixing me up. We'll see you again here shortly because I needed to get alignment done. But other than that, the Silverado is pretty good. I spent a lot of time last night cleaning this thing. I mean, a lot of time cleaning this thing last night. I've been neglecting her. It's been about a month. So I spent 2 hours last night washing it and cleaning it. And now it's raining, which is normal. Leave me a comment down below if you have the same problem when you wash your vehicle. As soon as you're done washing, oh yeah, here comes some rain. Why wouldn't it? But that's okay. We can hose her off again. At least the inside's clean. And that's the biggest part that I was worried about. I want a nice clean inside, eh? Nothing like a good inside cleaning, Captain. But I guess I should put my seatbelt on for rolling here, shouldn't I? Because when you're rolling, you need to put a seatbelt on, they say. I think it should be personal preference and choice because it's your body, not nobody else's. But I guess they just don't want to pick you off the ground, which makes sense, I guess. To somewhat of a point. Depends on how hard you hit somebody. Hey, look, it's brightening up over here. Maybe it's gonna stop raining. Maybe. We got ourselves some fresh peach. And let me tell you what, fresh peach you cannot beat. Leave your comments down below and let me know if you like a peach. But we're gonna take a break here right now and make sure you subscribe, like, and hit that notification. Welcome any new subscribers. I'm glad you're here, but I just wanna remind you to make sure you subscribe. Got no projects right now. Blue Balls is pretty much done. The old golf cart Ruski there. I really like him. I don't think I'm gonna be able to sell him, Sean. You're right. But I got Decent up for sale and he's just not making any progress right now on the selling of the Decent. I think it's because he's a gasser. A lot of people want the electric for the campground. I bet you if I put Blue Balls up for sale, she'd be gone. Who knows what's going to happen with Blue Balls or Decent. We're just playing it by ear, but I gotta get another one to fix up and sell because that's what I want to do. Leave a comment down below if you want to see another golf cart project. Maybe we'll go green on this one. What do you think? Red, blue, green, Captain. Actually, I should pick up Ray's golf cart. He wants me to fab it up for him, but I don't know if he's gonna want the budget. Give me $2,000, your golf cart, and she'll look mint, maybe. Nah, I won't cover it. Got a lot of labor there, Captain. How are you all doing anyways? Make sure you comment down below and let me know, because I always like to know what you guys are up to. We got ourselves a dump truck up here. Going nice and slow and easy and careful and gentle. He's probably gonna get me all dirty. I'm gonna slow down a little bit. Right now he's doing, I don't know, 70 kilometers an hour. We'll give him a few minutes because I'm not in a rush. Still got 40 minutes to get to work and I got a 10 minute drive, so we're doing okay. Look at that, no lights in the dash. Can you freaking believe it? Holy. Pretty sure the gas cap was my problem. The evap code. My gas cap was cocked. Captain, $40 for a gas cap now. What's really going on? It's a freaking gas cap. $250 for a used drive shaft. Figure that one out. Used parts went up. I don't know how. They had them before the COVID hit. I was going to get one last year. It was $150. Now it's $250. Good old Sarnia Ont wreckers going to fix me up with a drive shaft. Let's let you know what happens there. That'll be continued part of the video. Let me know in the comments below if you want to know what happened. Frank. Haven't used that radio in a while. The old CN radio. Kind of laid back off the old train since I got the fine for trespassing because I was over top of a train. Figure that out. What happens if you're on top of an overpass above the train going under the overpass? Is that trespassing? I don't know. Leave a comment down below if you know the answer to that question. This dump truck's doing 80, but I'm okay with that. We'll just drive along at 80 with them. How you doing? Slow and steady wins the race. Wonder if I'll have my hot rodder come up behind me from good old Macweld. Yeah, I know where you work, lady. You need to slow the hell down if you're watching this video. Red Dodge Journey, lady. You're gonna get yourself a ticket one morning. You drive like an idiot. Smarten up. Any of you guys at Macweld watching this video, make sure you let her know I know. And I'm gonna confront her one day with a camera. You tell her. I don't care what she's doing, but puts other people in danger than I care. And you're not supposed to pass on a solid line in a hill. So, you're putting people in danger, lady. Why wouldn't you? I've never passed on a solid line. Actually, this might be her coming up behind me. I should just sit every morning and wait for her, right? did just pull out in front of her and not let her pass me. Hold on a minute here, Jim. It might be her. We might have some action here this morning.
Aw, dick.
Can't tell. No, don't think so. No, that's a Honda CRV giving the old pass through. Get her done,
son.
Do the double. Yeah, you can. Aw, you chicken. You didn't do the double pass. Oh, now he is. He's like, yeah, I can. Friggin' right you can. Look at that. That's awesome. What other friggin' YouTube channel can you go on and see that kind of shit? None. Just Life with BillSiff. Oh, he passed two people. There must be somebody in front of him. Oh, there is. He passed two people. So actually, the dump truck isn't going slow. He's going slow because there's someone in front of him. Fuck! What was that?
I know what it was. I need to drink coffee.
Oh, I know what it is. I'm too early. I'm pretty sure it's because I'm too early. That lady comes by me when I'm running late. So if I wait 4 minutes, she'll be coming. Should I pull over and wait 4 minutes? I wonder if I should. She's got to be coming. Look at that thing. Should check the weather today, see if it's going to rain all day. Pretty sure it is. Just feels like it. One thing weird about Sarnia, we have the plants here. We have, like, Chemical Valley, it's called. It's a whole bunch of, well, you've seen it in my videos. And for the last, I don't know, 4 or 5 thunderstorms, as soon as it gets near Sarnia, it just goes around it. So I'm wondering if the plants are putting out some kind of new juice or something into the air that's causing the clouds to say, fuck you. What do you think? Leave a comment down below and let me know what you think. Thinking about hooking onto the trailer and just taking off somewhere without booking. Put the generator on the back and just hit the road, Jack, and see what happens. That'd be all right. We should try that someday together. That air conditioner's working. It's not cold enough out to have that thing cranked at me. Holy cow. Have an eye. The old Silverado's not afraid to make you cold. I'll tell you that right now. Don't know if you guys remember, I used to hang around with Pug One. Yeah, I used to hang around with him. Called the other day. My work, not me. Called the other day. And needed a window put in one of his backhoes that he bought. So I went out there like a normal worker and did it for him. And it actually turned out pretty good. And he was actually pretty decent to me. So that's a good sign. It's always a good sign. But like I said, I had nothing against him anyways. I just didn't really enjoy hanging around with him anymore. But when you haven't seen him, well, sorry. Just in case you know me and you've been here a long time, then you know what you know. And then I know what I know, and that way you can know what I know, and we can all know together. That's the way it goes. I don't know what the hell I was just saying there, but hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Why wouldn't you? Well, we're almost to this place that I go to some days where you have to kind of work for someone else. So I got to go there and do that and get it over with and see what else brings the day. So hopefully everybody's having a good day like me. I'm glad you're all here. I'm not sure how long this video is. Probably another 6 or 7 minutes or anyways. That's what we do. When we're in between projects, we do a little chat together. So have a good day. Be safe. Love y'all.
You know what to do for now.